All right, we are live streaming. This is His Hot Radio Behind the Scenes. What's up, everybody?
Hey. So I'm really excited for tonight, though, because this is one of my favorite people, even though I got to talk to him just a little bit one time.
You said I was hogging him up, probably because we were talking about guy stuff, you know, video games,
guys,
Star Wars.
See, now he's stereotyping, putting people in the box.
We were talking about Star Trek, all that good stuff.
Okay. So are you trying to suggest that Super J does not know about Star Trek? Are you kidding me? Oh.
Uh-oh. All right. We're going to have to get into that. All right. Count down in three, y'all. Let's do this. One, two, and three.
You're tuned in to Above All Lies Show, giving the scoop and the latest on how the story goes. Broadcasting from Vegas, in case you didn't know. Worldwide Great Commission, that's the gospel. Discussing topics of standard, it's righteous living. Bumping them bangers and interviewing different Christians. Who's hot, who's not, does it really matter? It's His Hop, non-stop, focus on the ladder. Stay tuned to the dial and turn that volume up. This faith radio, Jesus is who we lifting up. So in your ears, we gon' be here for a minute. It's my bro, D-Bro, he about to come with it.
Hey, 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 what's going on, y'all? This is your boy, D-Ro, coming at you from the headquarters, y'all. This is Club His Hop Las Vegas. We are a Christian nightclub located by the Strip. The address is 3945 East Patrick Lane. Once again, that's 3945 East Patrick Lane, Unit D. We turn up for Christ up in this spot. Even though we're close by the Strip, we outshine every light because we shine the light of Christ throughout our city and throughout the whole world. And tonight we have another show for you. I want to welcome you to the His Hop Radio Show. And before we get into everything, I want to remind everyone to download our app. Yes, we do have an app and we want you to download it. That means we want you to take it with you wherever you go, so that we can keep you in the mind of Christ. We're going to pump that, those holy beats and those holy lyrics in your ear everywhere you go. So go ahead and check us out in your app store. His Hop Radio. And download that app. And also we have events here in the spot the second Saturdays. Actually, throughout the month now, we do events. It doesn't matter. We just do events. We just went through the Stellars. We had back-to-back events. So get connected with us so that you can find out what's happening in the spot. And also want to invite you out to our Sunday night services. We are a verse-by-verse, chapter-by-chapter ministry. We don't leave anything out. We comb over the Word of God because we know that that is the only way that we're going to grow spiritually. The Word of God is our lifeline, y'all. So come 6 p.m. Sunday nights. Once again, 3945 East Patrick Lane is the address. Come out and join us. And tonight we're going to get into an awesome show. We have a returning guest. One of my favorite guests, because we get to talk about cool stuff. But before we bring our guest online, I want to show some love to my one and only, my wing woman, Super J. She's back in the house tonight, and I'm excited. And so, Super J, take it away.
Hey! Hey, everybody. It is Super J here. And yes, we are back in the house tonight. I'm so excited. It seems like I'm in and out, in and out, in and out, because there's been so many different things going on, but we are back in the place where we are supposed to be, and I'm really excited about that. I'm also quite excited because not only is one of DJ D Rhodes' favorite people on tonight, but one of my favorite people is on. Clap, clap, clap. Applause.
Well, there you go.
We have Ben Knight. this evening, all the way from North Dakota.
Yeah.
It's cold out. Is it still cold out there? I wonder. But anyway, he's going to be with us, and we get to talk about a lot of stuff. He's got the new track of the week, and we're just getting ready to rock it out. And yes, I can talk about cool stuff, too, now.
But of course. But of course. You're Super J. Come on now.
Of course I am. Very eclectic.
Yeah. Okay. And so before we bring him on, we do have a couple of announcements we have to get out there. Of course, we have our big event coming up. Our boy, Derek Miner, he's coming out to Club His Hop, y'all. Yes, the boy was with, he was with Reach Records. He left Reach. Now he's got his own label, and he's got some hot fire. Come on out to that event. It is April the 28th. It's coming up pretty soon. And you have an opportunity to win free tickets if you go to our app community. The 10th, every 10th post will win a free ticket, a free entrance into that. So you don't want to miss that. And I don't want anyone saying, oh, I couldn't afford a ticket, because we're giving away a lot of free ones, y'all. In May, May 19th, my big brother, DJ Mr. E, is coming out. Super J remembers him because we tore it up for her birthday.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We have. It's going to be an annual now. It's my annual birthday party.
Birthday bash, y'all. You definitely got to come out to that. And
one big party.
We also want to go ahead and play their promo video so you guys can get a visual and understand exactly what's coming our way. Come on, Vegas, do not sleep on the One Big Party Tour. They're going to be here May the 19th. So
DJ Mystery and Sean Oliveira.
Let's go ahead and check it out, y'all.
These are my guys. They're going to party with and for me.
I think so. I'm not sure. What's up now? So that's what I'm talking about. The One Big Party is coming to Club His Hop. You
that's
don't want to miss
Super J's birthday weekend, everybody.
Woo! Birthday bash, y'all. Okay, so now let's get into the new track of the week and our featured artist for tonight. Super J, you already talked about.
Yes, we have Ben Knight, but okay. I did not talk about the new track of the week, which is getting ready to be something really cool. It should I give him the name of the new track?
Yeah.
Okay, it is called The Light Side of the Dark Knight by Ben Knight.
Ben Knight, yes. The Light Side of the Dark Knight. And we know the Dark Knight is Batman, right? Batman, so he's gonna take us into this genre this new genre is called nerdcore, which I'm really excited about, man, because I like Batman. I like all, you know, I love gaming on the Xbox and all that stuff. So this is the lighter side of Batman. But let me explain.
No, the lighter side of the Dark Knight.
The Dark Knight, which is Batman. She's like, oh, I'm giving it away. Okay, so this is how it works. So if you have a track, you have a song, and you want to more exposure, submit it to radio@hishotnation.com. Submit it to us, and we will put it in heavy rotation for a week straight. And while it's in heavy rotation, tell your followers and your friends to download the His Hot Radio Show app and vote for it every time it plays. It's going to play every other hour, right? So get on there and listen to it. And when it plays, there's this little star that pops up. Click that star and you can rate it from 1 to 5. Go ahead and show some love and give it a 5-star rating. And once this song gets enough votes, we will add it to permanent rotation. And after that, you can request it. And it can become the most requested song of the week as well, and it'll end up in heavy rotation again. So So we're showing love. You know, some other stations, they'll do a competition. They'll do a thing where one song will go up against another one, and they'll vote for it. But here we're going to give you a whole week to get your song out there. So with that being said, here is the new track of the week, our brother Ben Knight with The Lighter Side of the Dark Knight, y'all.
Woo!
Here is the new track of the week.
Let us know if it's hot
or if it's not.
Hashtag hot or not on our Facebook page, His Hot Radio. The official radio station for Club His Hot Las Vegas. Here we go.
But inevitably, it always happens to me. My day gets cut off short by the Joker in Harley. Guess that's the way it goes. This is the life I chose. Break a criminal's nose, yeah, it helps with my woes. When I'm in the Batmobile, I crank Kiss from a Rose. That song always makes me cry. I wonder if Seal knows. I've always wanted kids, that's why I took it. Dick Grayson had to stop after Jason Todd. He tried to punch my face in. Would love to meet a girl without a leather suit and claws who isn't into plans of taking up a father's cause. I know I seem angry, but it's just a mechanism. Just ask Alfred. I've got a sunny disposition. It's not who I am, but what I do that defines me. And what I wanna do is let the whole world see. When people look at me, who is it that they see? Bruce Wayne, a billionaire, a cowering freak. There's no escaping, no matter how hard I try. I wanna show the light inside of the dark night.
Gordon's always flashing that best signal in the sky when I'm crocheting potholders, and it's hard to deny that it's hard to fight crime when your nerves are all fried. So I'll watch a little Lifetime, have myself a good cry. Bane wants to break my back, Two Faces double whack, Poison Ivy's plants are fat, wish my garden looked like that. Riddler's always leaving clues, and Scarecrow is a fright. Would like to have one day where I can have a game night.
With people look at me, who is it that they see? Bruce Wayne, a billionaire, a cowering freak. There's no escaping, no matter how hard I try. I wanna show the light inside of the dark night. I'm not just Gotham's Dark Knight, more than a man who fights crime. A vigilante with a poet's heart.
The lighter side of the Dark Knight, man. That was, what'd you think, Super J?
So, I mean, I love the fact that he considers himself the Weird Al of Christian hip hop, because it really is. And I love the way you put your hooks in there. I loved the music. The beat was sick. I mean, it was really nice. Wait. Ben, it was dope.
It was dope. Come on now. And with that, let's go ahead and bring our brother Ben online. Ben Knight, welcome to the His Hop Radio Show, my brother.
Oh, thank you. Super Jammin' Jay and Sensational Sam.
What's up, brother? Did you hear...
What is going on?
Did you hear Super Jay's little commentary?
I did, and you know what? I think Super Jay is dope.
That's an inside joke right now.
Right. I was like, it was dope.
All right, brother. Well, before we get into the song, I want you to explain to our listeners what nerdcore is. Some people might not be up on that as of yet. As a matter of fact, you're the one who explained it to me. So what's nerdcore all about, brother?
So nerdcore. So, you know, I've always been into hip hop my whole life. And, you know, a few years ago, I heard an artist by the name of MC Lars, and I just really liked what he was doing. You know, he was literally rapping about, you know, pop culture and nerd culture and just these goofy, silly songs. And I was like, you can do that? Like, you don't have to rap about, like there's a lot of things in my life that I don't know anything about. So, like, when I listen to hip-hop, I'm like, I don't have those experiences, so I can't talk about that. So I thought, oh, man, like, I can just rap and sing about, like, movies I like or, like, video games I like and stuff like that. Like, that's really cool. That's dope, Super J. So, you know, I just thought, man, that's a really cool genre. But like in the Christian community so far, it hasn't been like super accepted yet, like, because it's just not treated as respectable. Like, you know, it's just kind of like, you know, maybe like I'm taking the form and I'm making fun of it, but I'm not. I'm taking, you know, the music and the production and what I'm doing seriously. But the lyrical content is that of like nerd culture or pop culture or just things that I think are funny. So, you know, and what's really funny is I really do think about like every single lyric that you heard from that song, no matter how dumb somebody might think it is, like a lot of thought went into that song. So that's, I mean, for the most part, nerdcore, you know, and it was kind of invented by a hip hop artist by the name of MC Frontalot, who just happened to have a song called Nerdcore Rising. And so people kind of just went, oh, okay, nerdcore. And so it just kind of came from that. And so here we are, man. I'm just trying to, you know, I'm trying to make nerdcore respectable, you know, trying to give it a little bit of headway in the Christian hip hop community. So far, I'm not winning, but I'm not a quitter, man.
Come on, keep it coming, brother.
Well, I think one of the reasons is there's two reasons that it's probably not taking, you know, the taking off like you would think it would. But one of it is it requires a lot of thought. You have to really pay attention, and you have to understand. You have to really know. So there's going to be a certain level of intelligentsia that is required for your songs. So it's not just, you know, just a beat and a hook and you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There's a lot of thought that has to go into that.
I think it has to be, like, if you're going to talk about a series, right? If you're going to talk about a franchise, whether it be Star Trek or Star Wars, you got to be into that to appreciate the song. Yeah. If you don't like those type of franchises, and then it might miss you a little bit. But these different shows, they have a big following. I mean, you have what is that big event they have?
Comic-Con.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I imagine, I don't know what the number is, but I imagine
there's millions of people
are into that. Yeah, they dress up and And I mean, I would like to go one day. I think we had a couple in Vegas.
Vegas, yeah. Here's the
we have to dress up and go, Super J.
So people not only have to know the story, but they have to understand the backstories and the innuendos. Like he talked about Seal. People have to know, well, who is Seal? Well, he just said he cries on the song Kiss from a Rose. Yeah. Well, that's the song. That was the theme song of The Dark Knight.
Of The Dark Knight.
So you have to know all of that stuff.
And that song's dope, man. I love listening to that right now. All right, Ben, well, go ahead and break down the lighter side of The Dark Knight. And, you know, I gave it away early. I said it was Batman. For everyone who don't know, The Dark Knight is Batman, but... That's true.
But it's all good. And actually, if I can real quick, I'm going to touch on what Super J said, because she is right. I mean, as far as a lot of what I do, you know, yes, you listen, you do kind of have to know a little bit of what I'm talking about. But what I always try to do is, like, for me, the reason that I like certain hip hop is that I love storytelling. Like, I don't really care about, like, I mean, you know, it's fun to write a song about going out with your friends or hanging out or, you know, whatever, going to the club or what, you know, whatever it is that you're singing about. But like, if you're going to do that, like, tell me a story, like make me think that I'm there wherever it is that you're going to or whatever it is, the place that you're talking about. Like, by the end of the song, I want to feel like I had that experience with you. And that's kind of how I hope that sometimes when I write a song, like, you know, like with the lighter side of The Dark Knight, it is kind of a timeline thing. So like, you know, the beginning of song, you know, we're kind of going through, like, you know, Batman is actually, you know, you find, I mean, we all know Batman, like, you know, Batman's this brooding, you know, and actually if you read the comic books and really pay attention, like, Batman's crazy. Like, Batman is
crazy.
Completely, he's completely two tacos of a combination platter. I mean, he's nuts. So, like, you know, going in with that, you know, it's kind of fun to spin it on its head and go, you know, what if Batman is actually the super sensitive guy who just puts on the facade of being like a jerk or, you know, like this tough guy? And what if he's actually this guy that's like, man, I wish that I could, like, go out with a woman and have a nice dinner. Like, I wish that, like, I could go dancing, and I wish that I could, like, you know, come home and play board games, and I wish that, like, I could sit at home and, you know, when I'm having a, you know, when I go outside and I beat up some bad guys, like, you know, I don't come home and, like, make a bunch of bat tools. No, man, I come home and I watch some Lifetime movies, I cry, I eat some Haagen-Dazs, you know, that's what I do. And so I just thought it would be really funny to just kind of, again, take Batman and just flip and, like, take everything we know about Batman and just completely flip it on its head and go, you know what? No, Batman is not this brooding, tough character. He is a walking sissy who likes to bake and crochet and, you know, take care of his 17 cats.
Oh, man, that right there, that blows your mind. You know what I mean? Because that is the total opposite of what we know Batman to be. And I want to say this. I think in the world we're living in today, there are so many issues that confront us. And there are so many things that we deal with in our society. I think it's good to take a break. You know what I mean? I think it's good just to let our hair down, you know, watch a good movie or... you know what I mean? Just take a, and I that's what I look when I hear about nerdcore or I hear songs like this. It's kind of like, hey, line up, take a break, let's laugh, let's do this. You know what I mean? Let's read a comic book or something. It's okay just to take a vacation sometimes. You know, and I think God allows that. I know in the Bible, he would tell the disciples, here, let's go and depart from the crowd, and let's go to a secluded place and refresh and get refilled and stuff like that. So is that something that you want to accomplish with your music, or am I way off base on what you're trying to do?
No, I mean, you're kind of going on the right page there. I mean, it's for me. So, like, you know, you've heard a lot of my stuff, and, you know, other people out there that are listening probably heard some of my stuff. Like, I don't really write serious songs, like, for the most part. Now I haven't even released my new record yet that's coming out on April 20th, and I'm already writing for the next one. And there will be one or two serious songs on there because I do want to try to incorporate some truth. But, you know, for me, like, you know, as a Christian, and I do refer to myself as a Christian nerdcore artist. Like, I know for years everybody's, you know, kind of like, no, you know, like, you know, Lecrae said it, and I'm not necessarily throwing him under the bus, but he, you know, he said, you know, I'm not a Christian artist. I'm a rapper, but I'm not a Christian artist. I'm a Christian, you know. And we've heard the argument over and over again from, you know, and not just again, I don't want to throw him under the bus. You know, I mean, thousands of Christian artists have all said the same thing. Like, you know, I'm a Christian, but I'm not a Christian rapper. I'm not a Christian hip hop artist. I am a Christian nerdcore artist in that, you know, I have been born again through Christ, and that I choose to serve on a day-to-day basis. But I just happen to write songs that are just a little goofy. And, you know, for me, there's just so much bad stuff in the world, man. Like, and there's so many experiences that I can't really speak with authority on. You know, I have no idea what it's like to live in an inner city. I have no idea what it's like. You know, I grew up poor and things like that. But, like, I mean, there are just so many experiences that I just cannot intelligently speak about. And like you said, man, right now there's so much hate in this world and just so many bad things. It's just like, you know, when I've got a mic in my hand, I just want to have a good time. I want to lift people up, man. I want everybody to walk away going, you know, I thought this was going to be cheesy. I thought maybe, you know, some of the songs were corny, but man, he was fun, you know? And then if I can do that and then just sprinkle a little bit of Jesus while I'm doing that and just say, look, you know, I'm here to have a good time. We're having a good time, but like, I just want to say, like, look, man, Jesus Christ saved my life, and that's why I can walk with my head high, and that's why I can sing these silly songs. You know, if you want to talk about it, let's, you know, let me step off the stage. We'll go back here. We'll talk. I'll pray for you, whatever. And but yeah, I mean, that's kind of me, man. Like, I don't want to limit myself. You know, I think in just like every single genre, there's a lot of limitations. You know, and you know, I have friends whose kids that are 2 to 12 years old, and they listen to my stuff all the time, you know, going to soccer practice or whatever. And even their moms dig it. And then, you know, even my friends like it. So it's like, you know, I'm trying to find music that we can all kind of go, all right, well, it's not necessarily my thing, but, you know, I like the chorus or I like your hook. I don't really like hip hop. You know, and then you got guys that are like, oh man, I kind of liked your flow, but I didn't really like the singing. So, I mean, you know, hopefully what I'm doing is just kind of wrapping up this big package and saying, look, man, right here, I've got life, I've got hope, I've got some happiness. It just happens to be kind of a goofy package, but, you know, if it puts a smile on your face, that's fantastic.
So, Ben, I don't know if anyone has ever told you this, but even the way you describe things, your descriptions are actually quite comedic. He just said that he'd like to do this and just sprinkle a little Jesus on it. And I'm like, is that like a Catholic baptism sprinkling? Or, you know, it's not a John the Baptist baptism, you know, full of submersion. Just sprinkle him a little bit, right?
Well, you know, it's one of those things where, like, I mean, again, like, I mean, Jesus is, you know, people, I've always really disliked the phrase, you know, Jesus is the reason for the season. And I just like to cut off that last part and just say, no, man, Jesus is the reason. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, but I don't feel comfortable. And what I mean by I don't feel comfortable is like, I'll talk Jesus to anybody. I mean, I will sit down and have a 5-hour conversation with an atheist and we'll both walk away smiling, going, hey, let's go grab some lunch, you know? Mm-hmm. But I just, you know, you know, while my songs are silly, like that's still, you know, in the back of my head is always like, you know, to win as many as possible, right. Win as many as possible. So, you know, I just, you know, again, like I think there are things that I'm going to do or say with my music that, you know, some of the more serious artists just can't. I mean, they just can't. And, you know, like I said, it's not a one is better than the other or one is not as valuable as the other, but it's just, you know, we've all got a part in this play, you know, called life, and we're just trying to figure it out. So, you know, I just hope that, like, and what I meant by the sprinkling Jesus is just, you know, I just hope that, like I said, I'm not kind of one of those people that's like, I'm not going to do an hour of preaching and do 10 minutes of music. I'm like, no, I'm going to get out there and play music for an hour. And then I'm going to say, hey, look, I'm a Christian. This is what I believe. I'm not going to push it on anybody, but I'm telling you right now, if you come back here and we talk about it, like, it's going to change your life.
So. Amen. Amen. And what I like about this, we're called to reach all people, all walks of life. You know, Paul says, I become all things to all men so that I might win some. And my experience, I ran a clan on Xbox for about 7 years. We played the first person shooter games, Call of Duty, Rainbow Six Vegas. We actually started off on America's Army, and it was the same group of guys. We grew to be like 30 people that we would get on here and game together. We would practice. I mean, we were trying to go pro for real, you know what I'm saying? And we reached a high rank, you know what I mean? I'm proud of my Xbox days, y'all. But
obviously.
But here's the, I know, but here's the thing, though, even with all that, I got to know the people pretty good. Even though I never met them in real life, I got to know them pretty good. And in the back of my mind, I was always saying, why don't we start a ministry on Xbox and PlayStation? I mean, people, they spend hours and hours on these games, you know, and I know there's a balance to life, you know, you can't neglect the family on the game, but it happens, you know.
You can sprinkle a little Jesus.
Sprinkle a little Jesus on there. Like, why not come out with a clan, a Christian clan, and get in there and infiltrate and start bringing Jesus to the people? But here's the thing. Some of the people that I was able to know, there was one particular guy. He was actually a Marine. He was in the Marines, and he was one of our generals, in the clan. And we would set up matches, and we would play. Like, some of our matches would last for 4 hours, you know what I'm saying? But it turns out this guy was dabbling in witchcraft, and he would say some things about it. He wouldn't hold no punches, but he didn't know that the clan leader was a Christian, a born-again Christian, you know what I mean? And so I kept planting seeds and I kept, trying to minister to him and find a way where I could, really give him the gospel. And finally, when I came all the way out with it, that, hey, I'm a Christian, I believe in Christ, man, I think he broke his Xbox, man. I don't know what that dude, man, he got off, and I haven't heard from him since. And so I'm still praying for him, but I'm praying that the seeds that were planted will harvest, you know what I'm saying? So I think that there's a place for music like this. That's just my opinion. I'm an evangelist in nature anyway. That's my spiritual gift, is evangelizing. So maybe I'm just looking at it through my lens, you know what I mean? So what do you think about that, Ben?
No, I think you're right. I mean, it's like I said, we've all got a part to play. And I've talked about this before in other interviews and stuff, but like, one thing that I've always really liked the idea of is when it comes to our calling. So like, you talk to a college kid going into or coming out of college, and especially a kid that's going to a Bible college, and they're super excited because they're like, man, God's called me to do this. God's called me to, to evangelism. I'm supposed to go to Africa, or I'm supposed to go here, or I'm supposed to go there. And, you get the same thing from these kids going in as they do coming out. Sometimes they're like, oh, man, I'm supposed to do this. I'm supposed to be a youth pastor, and I'm supposed to be a pastor, which I need to start a church. And that's awesome if that's really what God is calling you to do. But in my head, the way I see it is, like, I feel like it's like a DMV. It's like you go to the DMV and you grab your number. Like, that's how I feel sometimes Christians treat their calling. Like, it's almost like they go to the Department of Callings, and they go in there and they grab their number and they're like, oh, cool, I got evangelism, I'm going to Africa, cool. And it's just like, what if, like, and this is, again, we all have to kind of search, our souls and really pray and really, really drop ourselves and allow God to work in us and figure out what it is that we're called to do. And if, honest to goodness, if our only calling is to minister to one person, like if you if you're like me, you live in a small town, like if my ministry is to only talk to the one guy who owns the supermarket in town, like if that's my only ministry, and that's what God has called me to do, that is not any less than God who, you know, I mean, it's no different than God calling, you know, Super Jay to like go out and bring in a million, like, because it's still the same. Amen. Like, even though it's one versus a million, it's still what God has called you to do. And it's hard because as Christians, especially as young Christians, you know, they get so excited and they want to, you know, they want to just set this world on fire, and that's fantastic. But what if, I mean, again, what if God has put it in your heart and he says, no, you need to set this one person on fire. That's what you know, that's awesome. You're excited. Like, get excited about this. And it doesn't even mean that if God's called you, and again, I'm saying this all as somebody, like, I will never say that I believe God said this, or, cause like, if I could understand God, I wouldn't need God, but I do desperately. But so it's one of those things where, you know, I do believe that, you know, God, you know, what if, you know, God may have several callings on our lives. So, you know, it may be one of those things where he's like, no, you need to minister to this one person. Sweet. You did exactly what I told you to do. Guess what? Amen. Tomorrow, 3 billion. So Man. It's just one of those things where, you know, I mean, God is all powerful. God can do anything. So it's just, we don't want to limit. I mean, again, you know, it might just be a ministry to one person or 12 people. But I mean, what if that one act is the thing that just sets this whole world on fire and just changes everything? You know, it makes you wonder, like, because, you know, I don't really have many regrets in life, but one of them is that I know, and I think we all have, is there have been several times God has spoken to me and I've been like, nah, I don't feel like doing it. Or yeah. Like, or you just kind of make the excuse of, I don't think it was God talking to me. I think I was just probably just thinking about something and it popped into my head. It wasn't God. You know, and it's just like, it makes me wonder. I'm like, what in my life, and not even to be selfish, what would have happened in somebody else's life if I would have taken that opportunity to do whatever it is that was on my heart, you know? And that just, you know, like I said, that, I mean, I think you're right. I think whatever, playing basketball, playing video games, you know, whether you're just, you know, whether you're just the dude that sets up chairs at your church Sunday morning, I mean, like, it's all important. We've all got a calling, you know?
Amen. Amen. That's right, brother. All right, man, we're going to get back to some music. You actually have a new project coming out. Am I correct? Or what you been working on, brother?
You are 100% correct, sir. That's what I always say about you, sir. When somebody goes, what do you think? I'm like, he is correct. Always.
All right. But no,
you're right, man. Yeah, I got a new album coming out, a new EP coming out April 20th, coming out everywhere that you can find digital music, iTunes, Amazon, Bandcamp, Google Play, Xbox. It's going to be coming out on Xbox. Just letting you know, man.
Oh, okay. I'll be waiting. I'm going to be looking.
You go to the Xbox store, you can get it. But no, it's entitled Mild Stallion. And it's a funny title, just in that I consider myself. So it's based off of the cover art from Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. And if you've ever seen that, anybody listening out there, you know that their band is called Wild Stallions. And I consider myself a mild stallion. So I kind of just took the cover art from the movie, and instead of Bill and Ted riding on the phone booth time machine, it's me riding a microphone, you know, wearing Keanu Reeves clothes from the movie. No, man, it's fun, you know, like you said, I've been on this. I think it's my third time on here, and it's been a great blessing. It's awesome. People that listen to this show have been really cool about listening to or buying my previous work, or even just reaching out and saying, hey, man, I heard it on His Hop Radio. Like, that was a cool track, you know, or whatever. And that's a huge blessing. I love that.
Oh, praise God. I didn't know that. Wow.
So that's super cool.
Thanks for sharing that with us. We need to hear more stuff like that.
Yeah.
Hey, man. Thanks, brother.
Yeah. And so, I mean, it's, you know, this particular record, you know, the the last couple I've released, like I hope that I'm getting better with each one. I do know that the songwriting on this one's a lot better. I think the music's a little bit better. I think, and actually the thing that I want everybody to know about this album is there are little Easter eggs all over the album. And what that kind of means is I didn't want to do just a copy and paste record. Like, I didn't want to just record my vocals for a chorus and then just copy paste. I wanted it to be kind of like a punk rock record. I wanted there to be mistakes. I wanted there to be, you know, I wanted it to be a little rougher. I wanted it to feel 90s in that, you know, it's not perfect. You know what I mean? It's not, I didn't just hit a button and go, yep, that's good. You know, I didn't want people to think that I just went on the internet and was just looking for beats and went like, yeah, this will work. And then just, you know, I wanted to put some real work into this. And again, it's a silly record, but you know, if I can impart anything to my hip hop brothers in the Christian community, like, I am trying, guys. I swear, like, I'm really taking the genre seriously. I just write silly songs. So, but this one was a lot of fun. You know, like I said, I like doing the Dark Knight track, and then here in just a little bit, we're gonna hear the title track. And you know, I mean, this record kind of has a little bit of everything. It's got Batman, it's got a little bit of Bill and Ted, it's got a little bit of Final Fantasy X, if anybody out there has ever played that game.
So you really have to pay attention. You got to really pay attention to the song to get all that out of there.
Yeah, you kind of do, but like I said, I hope that as I'm doing these songs, like, I hope that I'm at least telling a story where, you know, you don't have to know what's going on. And in all honesty, like, whatever you can picture in your head while listening to whatever it is I'm singing about, it's probably better than anything I can come up with. So I mean, hopefully whatever I'm saying, you're getting a really awesome word picture in your head going, okay, well, I don't know what this is about, but this is what my brain is producing. So, and to go along with it, and you know, to go along with that, like, you know, I don't just write songs about, you know, things I like, you know, movies or video games or whatever. One of the songs that we won't be hearing tonight is called Weapons of Mass Distraction, and it's basically a whole song about how much, you know, Netflix and Amazon Prime and, like, you know, Hulu, you know, all, you know, Rokus and Apple TVs, like, this stuff, it just, like, consumes us. And it's, you know, the problem with that is, like, there's so much. I mean, there's so many shows and movies, and it's just like, how can we watch them all? You know, and it was actually inspired by the fact that a few years ago, I literally missed a day of work because I stayed up all night binge watching an entire season of a show because I couldn't shut it off. Like, I had to keep watching.
Yeah.
And I was just like, I literally called in and pretended I was sick, and I was just like, oh, Lord, help me. And, you know, so, I mean, that's the kind of, you know, I like being truthful, but being funny. And, you know, the last track on this album is probably the weakest, but it's one that I had fun with, and it's called Untitled, and in parentheses, the song with no name. And if you listen to that song, there, again, there's a lot of Easter eggs, and I don't want to give them away. If I come back on the show another time, we'll have to go through all the Easter eggs, but it's literally about me trying to sit. Like, I sat down, and I liked this beat, and I really, you know, wanted to write a great song, and no matter how hard I tried, I just could not come up with an idea. Like, I write my choruses first. Like, I'll write a song, or I'll work with a couple of guys, and we'll write a song, and I'll go back and listen to it, and the first thing that pops into my head as I'm listening to the chorus, or just while I'm listening to the song, I just go, okay, yep, that's what I'm writing about. And so then I just start with the chorus, and I'm like, okay, once I've got the hook and I know exactly what I'm talking about, then I can go backward, and then I can work backwards and just kind of bring myself up to the chorus. Well, this song, I sat for 8 months trying to write a chorus to this song.
Wow.
Could not figure out
anything. You're talking
anything.
About Miles Stallion,
no,
right?
He's talking about the song with no name.
The song with no name, okay.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah, Untitled. Super J's right. Yeah, it's an Untitled song. And so The reason it's called Untitled is because I literally could not come up with the chorus. So instead, I just wrote a song about not being able to write a song. So it's just...
Oh,
so that's
man.
Exactly what it is.
Man. You know, we're going to have to try to find that one, man, because now you got me curious. Okay, so talk about Mild Stallion real quick, since that's the one we have in the queue.
So this is literally, like, there's no... If you've ever seen the movie Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure, this will not surprise you at all. It's pretty much, you know, I try to be a little bit, you know, I've always considered myself something of a wordsmith, so I try to, you know, I do try to make it interesting. I mean, I am trying to tell a story, but it is basically kind of explaining the plot of the movie Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure, and you know, that's really pretty much it. I wish there was a better explanation that, like, I wish I could be like, well, actually, okay. Sam, it's kind of like the reconstruction of the United States after the Civil War. And then I kind of sprinkle in a little bit of, like,
Jesus.
You know, NASA. Yeah, there you go. Exactly.
Wait. He sprinkles a lot of stuff. He's got more than just Jesus. He likes to sprinkle. You know what I'm saying?
I know. Okay. But since he said sprinkling,
I know,
I keep using that one.
Okay,
I'm
brother,
like
let's go
Christian
ahead and
bakery over here.
We're gonna go ahead and play the track, and then after that, we're gonna go to our comments. I see we have a lot of comments out there, some good ones. We have Theo the Thespian is online,
Theo,
and he's made a few comments. So we're gonna get to that in a few seconds. But right now, let's go ahead and play this song, "Mild Stallion" by our brother Ben Knight, who is introducing us to the genre called nerdcore right here live on His Hop Radio.
Clean message.
And it wouldn't do that, huh?
It gave you a commercial.
It kind of. Let's see if we can do it this way. All right, we are experiencing
technical difficulties.
Yeah.
Wham. That's what happens when you do live shows. So sometimes you gotta bear with us.
It's still dope, though.
It's dope. We haven't even heard it, and it's dope. We know it's dope.
Super dope. Okay, so while we're doing that, we're gonna play another song by our brother until we get this one up.
Clean message.
Those are our sponsors right there. So, we're going to play a song, and then he's going to come back and tell us about it after we play it.
So good, just playing blitzball whenever I could. Sure, I lived in the shadow of a man named Jack, but he was a great blitzer, so I learned to accept. One day a man came, Arn was his name, and with him sin came. It would never be the same. I got sucked out of spirit, then met some Albed. Then sin came again and dropped me off at the set. Met a dude named Walker and Lulu the Mage. Kim Mari, who's a Ronso, who I learned had some rage. When Arn came around, I thought that I could go back, but he kept on dropping bombs, always kept me off track. That's when I met Yuna, only wish I'd met her sooner. At the first glance, you know I almost was a swooner. So I promised to guard her on land or on water. My eyes finally opened the moment they caught hers.
I never knew I'd feel like this. I give it a can't resist. Cause something happened on the way to the center again. She's got me wrapped up tight in this. These feelings I can't dismiss. Cause something happened on the way to the center again.
The Guado named Seymour, fighting spawn from the sky to the seashore. Summoners with the crazy onset sin war. If the faith stops dreaming, well then I'll be no more. But that's the chance that I'm willing to take, because there's so much more than just me at stake. When this is over, it'll tear me apart. The final Aeon is summoned and it'll be my heart.
You know, Leska, you're my dream. When I wake up, you're all I see.
Brother Ben, you there?
Yes, sir.
All right, all right. I knew better than to do that at the last minute, but I cannot play your song, Miles Stallion, tonight, man. I do apologize for that. But all that means is that we need to get you back on the show so we can play it. Is that cool?
Anytime, my brother, anytime.
All right, so what did we just listen to? We listened to the song "What Happened to the Way the Something Something."
Something happened on the way to Xanarkand.
Yeah, Xanarkand. What's up? What's that about?
Okay, so yeah, this is one that is like every reference in this song. Like, if you don't know what it is, then you don't know what it is. So, It's about the video game Final Fantasy X. So it's kind of like, so the main character, his name is Tidus, and he kind of falls in love, or like, but dude, it would take us like a half an hour to explain this. So we'll do the cliff notes.
Yeah,
here.
Do
so
the,
like
the quick one. Yeah. So we can go to the social media.
So basically, it's just a song about the main character kind of falling in love with the main female character of the game. And there's just a lot of complicated stuff that goes into it. Like, you know, you kind of find out later on that he's not actually real. And once they kind of go through this whole, like, adventure, like, he's going to disappear and not exist anymore. And he knows it and she knows it, but they still kind of have this, like, they still fall in love and go, well, you know, at least we've got, you know, we got this time together. And Xanarkand is kind of the ancient city that he lived in, and that they go to kind of have a final battle kind of thing. So what's kind of funny about the titles, I kind of got it from this is going to be a really old reference, but I got it from a Phil Collins song. He's got a song called Something Happened on the Way to Heaven. And I was like, oh, I should say something happened on the way to Xanarkand. That'd be kind of fun. So, but okay. Yeah, I mean, in a nutshell, yes, that's pretty much what it's about.
All right. Well, let's go to our social media real quick. Suji, are you able to help me with some of these comments?
Yes, I think I can see Theo the Thespian, my buddy.
He's talking about what? The Dark Knight? What'd he say?
Yeah, so he said... Theo said, have you ever thought of Batman representing the devil? Probably. And then he says, the whole dark spirit. Something ain't right with Marvel. And then Ben Knight said, T-streaming, i.e. Theo the Thespian, another song coming. And so Theo the Thespian said, thanks, Ben Knight.
Look, she's a good narrator, y'all. She can read bedtime stories real good.
And then Ben Knight said, we are playing all kind of stuff, but it's all good. He says, there's another song, y'all. That's not the one, but it's all good. And so this is, you know what, Ben Knight? This is what I would really like to know. I would wonder what you would do with Doctor Who.
You know, I've thought about doing a Doctor Who song. If I can get enough people, I'll be honest with you, I've tried to watch, like, I'm one of those people, like, I have to be a completionist. So if I start something, I have to start from the beginning and go all the way through.
Oh,
and so far I've watched 2 episodes of Doctor Who, and I've had an easier time watching Linoleum Curl.
You know what? That's so funny because I'm not hilarious. Really the Doctor Who fan. My daughter is, and she got it from a friend of mine who happens to be just kind of nerdy, but he's a little strange. And so I really didn't get too much into Doctor Who, but there's a few, you know, some of the different stories that some of his different adventures are interesting. So
yeah, he's kind of strange to me as well. It's kind of hard to really follow him, but
who was that guy on Torchwood? The one that like didn't die, Captain. His name was it Jack something? You guys know Torchwood?
No, you lost me there. No, Super J's going there.
Yeah,
about Jack Harkness.
Yes, Jack Harkness. See, Ben Knight knows. There we go.
I was teasing her because she was a girl. I was like, you ain't gonna be able to understand us talking. You know what I mean?
Stuff. I'm like, dude, don't even get started with Super J. I'm gonna embarrass you.
She got me on that one. She got me on the okay.
I will say this, if I may. The next time I come on, I think I want to have Super J read me the book Good Night Moon.
Oh, Lord.
I don't know why. I suddenly hear Super J. Like, I want to hear Super J read like a little kid's book.
I would say he wants to hear that voice.
Okay, now we have a comment saying that it was basically a spinoff of Doctor Who.
Yeah, Torchwood.
Okay. All right.
That's why I kind of thought about it, because he was saying that he didn't do Doctor Who, but I actually liked Torchwood.
Oh, so
I did like that. Yeah, I did like Torchwood.
Okay. All right, Mom, I got some research to do.
Hey, Israel, what's up?
All right, so Ben, tell everyone your contact info if they want to go ahead and get with you, download your music, and support this new genre, nerdcore, y'all.
Nerdcore.
The Christian nerdcore artist.
Yeah, totally. So please, like everybody, like I love to talk. Like, I, you know, when we get done off the show here, I think Super J and I are just going to talk for like 17 more hours. But like, I love chatting with people on social media, man. I love it so much. Like, it's one of my favorite things. You can follow me at Ben Knight Hip Hop, BENKNIGHT Hip Hop. Same thing on Instagram at Ben Knight Hip Hop. My Facebook is Ben Knight, again, like pretty similar, facebook.com/ Ben Knight Hip Hop. Yeah, I mean, like I said, I do kind of run 2 Facebook pages, because, you know, unfortunately the way Facebook runs, you only get about 10% of your followers who actually see what you're doing, because Facebook just controls everything, man. They're part of the government, man. Conspiracy theory.
They're part of the man.
And so, I kind of started 2 Facebook. So like, I do run 2 Facebook pages. I do the facebook.com/ Ben Knight Hip Hop, but I also do facebook.com/ Ben Knight Raps, just so I can. That's more of a personal account, so I can actually really reach out to more people and talk and things like that. And then also, if you guys just want to, you can go over to www.benknightraps.com. That's my actual official site. You know, there's bio, a little bit of music, lyric videos, stuff like that. The new EP drops April 20th, and like I said, that'll be on, you know, everything: iTunes, Bandcamp, Google Play. If you can listen, if it's a streaming, or if it's a, you know, Spotify, Pandora, everything. So, you know, wherever you can listen to music digitally, it will be there. So, but definitely, please get on social media and let's chat.
All right. Well, it is about that time. I'm going to let Super J give us some closing comments of the show tonight, and then we're going to get on out of here.
Well, all I can say is that, honestly, I was just very happy and excited to have come back. after a long, kind of a diverse roundabout way of in and out. But to come back and it be Ben Knight was just the most incredible, because you know I love me, so I'm Ben Knight. But anyway, so you were wonderful. I'm excited about your new project. Can't wait to hear it. Can't wait to have you come back and we can talk about it. We can go through the Mild Stallion and all of that. I can't wait. So thank you so much for sharing your wit, sharing your talent, sharing your anointing and all of that with us. I appreciate you, Ben.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And also, we have to go ahead and promote the Derek Minor event before we get out of here. And we're going to do that by playing one of his music videos at the end of the show. But basically, we're going to play it now. Before we sign off,
Ben says he calls him Derek Major.
Derek Major? I know, huh? Ain't no minor to that. You heard it at the name of Christ, yeah. So he's got a new video that he has just dropped recently. So we're going to play that. He's coming to Club His House. He's coming to Vegas, y'all.
Woo-hoo!
April the 28th. And we want y'all to come out and just enjoy it, man, and get blessed. You have a chance to win free tickets if you go to our app community. Free tickets. And the 10th person to post in our app community will win a free ticket to Derek Minor. I want to shout out to everyone. A quick shout out to my boy Resurrection. He's coming on here with his show Rise Up. I believe the first airing will be this week, this Thursday, 7 o'clock our time on the His Hot Radio app. So congratulations to him. And Ben, I'm going to let you say good night, brother, and then we're going to go ahead and play this music video by Derek Minor.
Good night, Las Vegas, and everybody listening out there. I love you. Jesus loves you. And from now on, I'm going to start wearing a t-shirt that only says I Heart Super J on it.
Come on down. Much love.
We love you too, Ben.
You got to come out here to Vegas and we'll just watch sci-fi all night, all of us. Super JB, she'll be telling us what's going on.
Because girls are smarter.
Exactly. Well, that's another inside
and we're
joke.
Dope, right?
Man, this whole radio show is just full of Easter eggs tonight.
Full Easter eggs.
Right, exactly.
All right, y'all. Well, this is your boy, D-Roll, coming at you from the His Hot Nation. I want to remind you to download the His Hot Radio app. Every Monday night is where you can catch us right here, 7 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. And wherever else you're at is the time it is, wherever you are. You know what I'm saying? So I want to remind you, just like I do at the end of every show, it's not about us. It's all about the Christ is in us. Stay tuned for some Derek Minor, y'all.
Everybody got the answers. They said that they plan is the master. They preach it to us like they passed.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah. The government treat us like cancer. The prison system make us bastards. I sent on the news and it's plaster. We can't even turn to charity. They make money off our tragedy.
They get the money.
If life is school of hard knocks, the street will teach you like academy. Everybody in a glass house tell us what we need to do to make it out. When they was born on a mountaintop, they ain't seen the bottom. They don't know the route. You think that we choose this environment?
Yeah.
I wish I could choose that entitlement.
Yeah.
Instead of being born in poverty and hungry hyenas surrounding me. The Fortune 500 won't hire me, so we create our own economies. With dope money, our salary, just to feed our families.
I close my eyes and pray that God deliver me.
Deliver me.
Churches moving to our hood, but they don't come and speak.
I don't know you.
Why they gentrify?
Gentrify.
We risk our life.
We risk our life.
Selling dope, probably die not knowing Christ.
Yeah.
Cold world, most of my kin, dead of the fund on brand new J's, Gucci belt, few gold chains. When you can put that change in a IRA, you just waiting. By the time that you retire, you be at the millionaire stage.
What's the point of saving anything? You dying, you can't take it with you.
Nah.
And that'll probably be tonight, cause the way that they shooting, the stretch out, they hit you.
I bet you God hear the prayers of millions of mothers.
Millions of mothers.
And they all sound the same, even though they sons in different gangs, and they shooting at each other right now.
Right now.
You hear her cries now.
Right now.
Now hear a hashtag, they debating about it online now.
Yeah.
What I call an abortion.
Abortion.
And since we're talking about abortions, we ain't put the clinics in our own hood. Somebody making a fortune.
Yeah.
We talk about these mothers like they out here killing for sport.
Killing for sport.
Or they kill a baby in their belly before it get brought in the war.
Pray for them.
You politicize our genocide, then use the victim as a scapegoat. But if you care like you say you do, you should talk less and do more.
Yeah. Yeah. Whole world, most of my kin, dead of the pen. That's why I'm an Eskimo. I bought an igloo and put on my wrist.
We're not an option, we gotta survive, so we taking risks.